Hey guys, it's Daps here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm excited to have you join me in this tutorial. Are you looking to create a website and you have zero budget to get things done? In this tutorial, I'll show you how to get free hosting. I'll show you how to set up your website for free with free domain name, free SSL certificate to make your website secured. And just in some few minutes from now, you are about to have your own WordPress website. So if you're excited about this, I think we should get started. So as you can see on my screen here is infinityfree.com. Just as you can see on their screen here, they said free website hosting. So literally, Infinity Free gives you access to host your website for free. Let's just get started for free. So we're going to hit the register now button. And what we just literally need to do here is to create a free account. So right now I'll pop in my email here. I'll also set a password. So the next thing for us to do here is to accept their terms and of service or terms and condition, whatever, and then hit the sign up button. Yeah, an email has been sent to my email address for me to verify. So I'll just come back here and I have my email here already. So I'll open this up and then I'll hit the verify email button. So, and that's it. First things first. Account has been created on Infinity Free, so I would agree to this. That's it. So now we have an Infinity Free account. So the next thing we want to do right now is to create an account inside Infinity Free account. So and that's very easy for us to do. So you can see that we can create three accounts here. So we can just hit the create button and let's close this. Yeah, lots of hearts here and there. That's exactly how they make money. Giving you free website, so you need to get comfortable with the heart. If you don't like this heart here, you may literally need to just get for a paid service. So the first step in creating an account is for us to choose a domain name, and for us to be able to do that, we have two options. Either we use a subdomain name for free that will be provided for us, or we use a custom domain name. To use a custom domain name is super simple. If you have your domain name registered somewhere that you have paid for, you can just click this and then set your name servers to ns1.infinityfree.com and ns2.infinityfree.com respectively, and then you can start using that domain name. Then point the domain name here and then you continue. Literally very simple. For the purpose of this example, says we want to do everything literally for free, so let's stick to their subdomain name. So now I can also choose what domain extension I want to use. By default here we have kesug.com, so whatever name I'm putting will be .thisdomain.com. I might just want to leave it at 42web.io, maybe that, and then I can just see maybe Daps Tutorial as my subdomain. So it will be daps-tutorial.42web.io, and then let's check availability. If that's available, that's the next thing to do. This domain name is already in use, unfortunately. Let me just do Daps Tutorials. Let's see if that's available. This seems to be available for us to use. This will be the account label, so username will be generated for us automatically. Also, an account password too can be generated for us automatically, a unique password. So let's leave this. Let's just hit the create account. All right, so you see your account has been created with username this, so that's fantastic. Let's just open our control panel. Yes, for us to be able to continue, we will need to approve. Yes. All right, so that's it. Before we go to create our website, let's come back here and let's come to free SSL certificates here. And definitely there's no certificate found. So let's come to new SSL certificate. So now here we're supposed to add a domain name, but I'm not sure I can remember that now. Let's come back here. Let's come back. We should have another email from Infinity Free, and let's open this up. So yes, you can see this is the domain name that we try to register, and let's copy this right now and let's come back here and let's paste that here, and then let's try to create this order. SSL has now been created, so you need to follow the steps below. What we need to do right now is to set up a CNAME, but good thing this can be set up automatically, so let's hit this button to set our CNAME automatically. So basically, what we need to do right now is to give this some time for this to propagate, since we have added our CNAME record. So this may take some few minutes. Let's just give it time. I will pause this video and wait till this actually is created. Okay, so after waiting for a while and doing the refresh, so you can see now that we have this now ready. And then we can request certificates. So you can see here your certificate has been requested and will be available shortly. We also need to give this a few seconds for this certificate to generate. I normally would recommend that you go through this process before you install your website, because yes, we can go ahead to install WordPress and then we leave all these things and we would design our website on an HTTP protocol that is not secured, and we will now need to upgrade it eventually when all of this is done. That's more stress. If you are a beginner, you really don't know much about all of these things, just follow my tutorial step by step. Make sure that you get this process done, you get a certificate ready before you continue this process. So that's my recommended procedure. After like a minute, I did a refresh and I find this. So you can see that you can install SSL certificate automatically, and you can see the SSL not found yet, but I can just click this to install this automatically. SSL certificate has been installed. It may take 15 minutes for it to become active. So this is everything we need to do here. SSL has been installed. We need to just give this some time for this to be active on our website. So after like about another 1 to 2 minutes, I did a refresh and now we can see that SSL certificate is installed, and we can see the expiry date for this SSL. And it means that we are good to go. We can continue further now designing our website. So let's come back to our control panel and we can scroll down or just search for Softaculous app installer. This would help us install WordPress on our domain name. And then the first application we can see here is WordPress. So why not? Let's click the install button. So we can scroll down a little and then we can choose the HTTPS protocol because we've already installed SSL on our website. And again, you can choose whether or not you want to use the WW version or the non-WW version. I just prefer that my website loads without the WW version. So if you choose this, either way, one will reroute to the other one. If anybody type www.mywebsite into their browser, it will reroute to myname.com without the WW. So either way, it's still fine. So that's it. The next thing we want to do here is to give our site a name. I will change this from my blog. I'll call this Tabs Tutorial. The description, you can give this any description you want to, but I'll just leave this empty. And also we can choose our admin username and password. I'll just call this admin. So for our password here, I will want to hide this and then I'll change this to a password I'm comfortable with. My email is constant here. I can change it if I want to. That's totally fine. You can manage backups, you can do limit attempt, you can do all those things here, but I really don't love to do all of those things. So you can select your language. For me, English language is perfect. Some other things you can do here, you have advanced session and also for theme, installing theme, but I really do not like messing around with those. So what I want to do right now is for me to just hit the install button. So this should automatically in some few minutes install WordPress. So we can see here that this is going. So this is 19% gone. So we're going to give this some few seconds to finish up. So fantastic. As we can see here, WordPress has been installed correctly. So this is the URL to our website and this is the URL to our WordPress dashboard. I would just want to open this. So if I click this, it will open a new tab and this should take me directly into WordPress. Good stuff. So you can see I am already in my WordPress dashboard. Super simple. So you can see SSL is installed. My page is secured. If I click this right now, you can see connection is secured. And that's literally what we want to do. So right now, we can go all ahead to now design our website. But before we start that, let's see what our website looks like currently. So if I come to Dabs Tutorial, I can just right click and open this in a new tab for us to see what this website looks like front end. Basically, this is what our website looks like right now at the front end. So let me show you how you can design your website real quick, regardless of the kind of website you want to create, literally for free. So let's come to the back end here and let's come to appearance. Let's come to themes. So this will show us the current active themes. So you can see that WordPress 2023 is active and we have 2021 and 2022 installed. But let's just take time to just delete this one since we don't need them. And also for 2022, I would be deleting these two as well. All right, so we have only 2023 active. So let's hit the add new button. So this will open up the WordPress repository for us to be able to find fantastic themes that we can install. Just even on our screen here, we can see Astra. I would be installing Astra, but there are quite a number of themes that you can install that will give you beautiful pre-made website templates that you can easily install on your website, customize or edit so that you can have your own website. So Astra is one of them. Hello Elementor is one of them in case you want to build your website strictly with Elementor, Page Builder. And also Ocean VP, Cadence theme, Neve theme. These are themes that will give you pre-made template that you can easily install. So right now, let's stick with Astra. It's installed. Let's activate this theme as well. All right, so theme installed. And the next thing we can see here on our screen here is thanks for installing theme. And this theme is suggesting that we install starter template. We need those templates like I mentioned earlier. So let's install and activate this template. Now we are required to choose a preferred page builder. Block editor, Gutenberg is the default WordPress editor. It's super light. If you want to have a very fast website, I would advise that you go with this. And then Elementor. Elementor is the most robust page builder out there, mostly used by all, because you get to find a ton of templates, a ton of add-ons that would work well with Elementor. So if you are more concerned about the UI or the UX of your website, then I would advise you go with Elementor. And also Beaver Builder, which is the least in my opinion in the pecking order if I would rank. But for the purpose of this example, I would work with Elementor. I just love to play around with Elementor. And now here I have a number of WordPress themes that I can install on our website. Know that all the themes here are not free. Some of them have this premium badge. It means that you will need to invest in Astra Pro for you to be able to use them. So you can also come down here and search for maybe a keyword in case you want to maybe design a blog. You can just type in a blog, and then there's a blog here, so you can even filter down the kind of blog you want to design. Maybe it's a news site, a magazine, a fashion blog. If it's an e-commerce website you want to install, you can come down here and filter down. And also it could just be an e-learning website. Maybe you want to design an online course website. You will find templates here that will solve that problem. So you can just filter down and search for whatever you're looking for. So, but I won't be going that route. I would just pick any random template here to install on our website. So this is Kate Stone. This is a fashion designer. I would just install this. If you scroll down, you find a lot of other themes that you can use. For the purpose of this example, let's just walk around with this. So this is exactly what the theme would look like. So you can see this is more like a blog. I can choose to change my logo here, upload a new logo and do quite some customization the logo is, but I wouldn't want to do that right now. Let's just keep and let's continue. Here I can also choose color palette, the different color palettes for me to customize our website. Just like I said, the front is poppins. I like poppins. I will leave that as is. I will be doing the customization eventually later. So let's continue. You can also agree to receive newsletters from them if you're okay with that. But for me, I will just submit and build my website. All right, congratulations. You can see your website has been built. This website just took 29 seconds to build. Isn't this amazing? So we can view our website here, but since we have the tab opened here earlier, now let's refresh this and let's see if we have our website. All right, so you can see we have our website here. Isn't this amazing? So this is literally like a blog, and I think I love this. So you can see how super simple and easy it is for you to design your WordPress website using Infinity Free. So if you come back here, I've seen this, thank you. You can tweet this, let people know you just built your website within 29 seconds using Astra. But I will just come up here to my right and I will exit to dashboard. Yes, I want to leave. So this will bring me back to my WordPress dashboard. So I can come to appearance, I can come to customize for me to customize my website in case you want to. In a customizer here, you have everything. You have robust settings for you to make changes to your website. So you can go Astra Pro if you want to. You can come to global here, you can change your typography, and that's the font on your website, the size, however you want that to work. You can also change the colors, you can mess around, choose appropriate global colors, and I think that's quite fantastic. Your container, your buttons, you can scroll to top, accessibility and block editor and miscellaneous. So you can also play with your header, your site logo. You can design this how you want them to show up, your primary menu in case you want to add menu to as well. So all those things are things that you can do. The breadcrumb, the blog, the page, the sidebar, footer. I really don't want to waste so much time here. So for footer as well, you can come down here, you can change the copyright in case you want to edit that into something quite different from what you have. So this is exactly how to customize this. This is not a WordPress tutorial. I wouldn't want to spend so much time here, but you can go through this. If you have any problem customizing your website, you can let me know in the comment section where you have issues. I can do further tutorials around that. Always ensure to hit the publish button so that you can publish the changes that you have made. WordPress is super simple to use, self-explanatory. I'm not sure you would have any problems using WordPress in case you are just learning WordPress basically. So that's it for customizing your website. So you can see your pages here, your comments here, the post here. You can go to your post, you can add more, you can add media, images, videos to your media library. I won't advise you to do videos because you don't have so much server resources with Infinity Free. I'll also advise that you optimize your images before you upload them. There are a lot of tools out there for you to optimize your image. So you can check that, you can search. Reduce the size to make sure the image is as light as possible. And you can add more plugins. You can come to plugins, install or add new. So that's pretty much what it is to it. So for our pages here, for every of the pages that you have the option to edit them with Elementor. I just need to let you know that you will not get the best experience using Elementor with Infinity Free because you might not have enough server resources. You might experience lags, serious loading time for your Elementor to load, so expect those things. So if you want speed, like I told you earlier, go with Gutenberg or Block Editor. So that's it. Just let me know your experience, if my tutorial was able to help you get a free website just like you can see on my screen. So that's my time for this tutorial. Subscribe to see more awesome tutorials from me. Take care of yourself and I'll see you in another one. Bye for now.